Very good evening, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, and thank you, Vimender sir, for inviting in a very, very prestigious and august meeting here. I think it's an absolutely great topic as a startup, and what is my responsibility as a last speaker is to end this as fast as possible so that everyone gets there, you know, to move ahead with the presentations. What I hear is, across the last 1.5 hours, that collecting data and synthesizing data is the key. And I truly believe that collaboration has to happen for that. Agriculture is self-healing by nature. And by nature, no puns intended, it makes it mandatory to collaborate for its own betterment. And that's what the direction is being hinted towards as the ecosystem in AgTech develops in India. You know, as Elon Musk says, that artificial intelligence will beat humans at just about everything by 2030. I don't think it stands a chance in agriculture. Agriculture is such vast, different fields to contain for the purpose of statistical quantification that the real veterans of agriculture know that exactly why agriculture does not fit nicely into a digital box of ones and zeros. Crop year is exactly the same. No field or even a single square foot of dirt is exactly the same. And at the end of the day, Mother Nature always has a few curveballs up her sleeve, which you know, throws all the data algorithms that we build far beyond what we can comprehend. Hence the advent of collaborative agronomic intelligence, as we call it, rather than artificial intelligence, is going to develop for sure between all the startups and all the stakeholders of the ecosystem and ensure that data works. And that's why the ecosystem of startups in agriculture, they should be very, very excited to build and scale each function that they are responsible for. I'll give you my example. This is a screen from my dissertation. I'm one of the veterans to get exposed to data and agriculture, both way back in 1998 as an agriculture graduate from IIT Kharagpur. This is my screenshot from my dissertation at IIT Kharagpur, where, you know, I was building a optimum nitrogen management as a function of planting date for maize. Sounds very fabulous, but I know how much data I had to collect from all over the fields to build a simple regression model like. Now, this is 2001, and during this, all the time, the whole decades of work that has been done in data sciences in agriculture is humongous. But what the startups, all of us in the startup ecosystem need to understand, customers never wanted a quarter inch drill. They want a quarter inch hole. So whether we are in pre-harvest or whether we are in the post-harvest, the idea is, what is the ultimate solution? As even Shubhang said, that, you know, not about the nice technology, but about the nice application. And understanding what is the, you know, hole that we are trying to solve is more important than the drill or the technology that we are trying to, you know, get in. If you see the trend over the last years, Is everybody able to see my screen?
Yes.
As you see, all the trends started in late 2000s, the Eureka moments in agriculture, when actually the agronomy was more and data was less. For example, climate and weather, application of different data mining methods for large weather profile data sets started, and that's where the whole AgTech boom, I think Big Bang kind of started. Immediately, soil and water followed, and we saw huge efforts in the late 2000s across the world of, you know, professors like Gerrit Hugenboom, etc., coming over for soil data sets. Water, we are working on huge to, you know, how does that impact the overall agriculture? But the entire thing was focused on the input side. That was the initial days of agri. And early 2010s, tech became the spearhead as IoT or computer vision tech slowly started to germinate within the realms of the developers. What we saw in that case is, once this toy of technology was there, a lot of shifts happened in the field of output, which is primarily how do we solve yield. So application of different technologies from, you know, satellite data to ground computer vision to some aspects of irrigation, how can we improve yield across agriculture commodities? And then came supply chains as a natural manifestation of, you know, how can we build various technologies at the various supply chain nodes of agriculture. I think in the end, the markets followed through, like Farmer Business Network and others, who kind of, you know, collated all that information at one place and kind of, you know, started building. But in all of this, you know, what happened is the aim to solve, which I call it that, you know, the quarter inch drill and hole rather than the quarter inch drill, it got a bit offset because of too little data. Not everyone was able to get every data that is required. This is what happened with, you know, why I showed the first screen of my 2001 dissertation, because it's just incredibly difficult to collect data in agriculture. You need new technologies, not just Excel sheets to enter. I need entirely different data sets for, you know, building a very, very comprehensible insight for a farmer. Similarly, the variables are too many, and each function of variable is not easy to solve. And then the bigger part that agriculture came is too many problems. So what had actually happened is, you know, the job that we really needed to do was, you know, a farmer simply crying out, you know, help me grow. And all the stakeholders saying, you know, help me buy. In the end, what they are doing is they are buying and then kind of processing and then forwarding it to the next supply chain node. But in this whole game, the job is as simple as that. But, you know, what if you divide that job into various activities, it's about monitoring, it's about analyzing, and it's about creating insights. And that's why we see that in the 2020s, it is going to be extremely different world. Because most of the startups today now have clearly started working on, you know, creating a niche for themselves. So building a monitoring solution which requires an understanding of the data and an understanding of the agronomy. This is the first piece, the most difficult activity which agriculture has to solve, the monitor bit. How to collect it and monitor it across time, across you know, space, and across, I would say, parameters. And that's where startups who build the origin from here have a much higher chance of, you know, building a niche and being a lot more sustainable company, you know, than just kind of being just a data collector somewhere and just kind of, you know, creating some insights. And I think that's where the second stage of startups or work activity comes in, which is analyzing. So somebody has to analyze. And I was very happy with what Sanjay has, you know, a good friend. Sanjay had told about, you know, that creating a platform where all the data sets come over and, you know, they are able to provide a better analysis. I think these are the models that are bound to be you know, germinating in the next decade, and that's where all of us will, as startups, will find a lot of value in, I would say, making the whole ecosystem successful. And this approach happens through a monitor analysis or an insight approach, where, you know, one company or one startup does the entire work. That is extremely impossible, honestly. One company cannot just get into collections, analysis, and then kind of creating insights. The entire portfolio sits at a very, very difficult point, because at the insight level, you need multiple data sets. And that's why we believe, you know, the way forward for most of is a solution approach rather than a product, where, you know, sensing or as we call, how do you sense data in agriculture, which can be defined as spatial data, temporal data, which is time-based, and compositional data, which is, you know, what is the chemistry of it. All three have to be, you know, excelled at by the ecosystem. And they have to be brought together to the solutions or people who understand agronomy and machine learning and artificial intelligence or whatever, you know, or a simple regression model or a simple Excel sheet with, you know, 500 sheets is not AI. You know, just kind of putting all that agronomy and data analysis into one place. And that's how you'll be able to serve both the farmer and the stakeholders. And I think this is what the 2020s should look like for most other startups. And it has already started happening where, you know, the engineering side of sensing, we are seeing a lot of startups working on creating a niche on the engineering side and a lot of them on the solution side. And I think what the ecosystem will evolve into is at a 3D of a spatial, temporal, and compositional, there are multitudes of solutions that will evolve. Each one, you know, with one company knowing what they are doing, how they are collecting, what they are analyzing, and how they are mixing the agronomy. And I think that's where the Indian AgTech system is developing, because as Himinder and Shubhang just discussed, you know, the cases for the other world out of India is not that easy, or the developing world is not that, you know, they are already technified and they have, you know, very, very linear models of technology applications. But in India, where, you know, the solutions have to have a lot more variable and a lot more analysis, I think collaboration is the key. And I think I would like to thank Fiki for actually, you know, coming up with this whole amazing thought of AI and collaboration, because I truly believe in this. I myself had a deep dive into this space, so I understand, you know, how important it is, how critical it is to, you know, have a data stack, and that data stack could be the future for India. And collaboration is the key, and that's where the startup should realize, with what I, you know, presented at the start, that, you know, this is 20 years back, but I think for the next 20 years, collaboration is what we would be focusing on. And a successful technology is only in the business of selling progress, not products. So I believe this is the future of India, that Indian startups in agriculture, primarily building an agronomic intelligence in agriculture, using their own niche and then using their own understanding, deep understanding of deep sciences for agriculture. Similarly, in Agnex, doing the same thing. We have built a niche in terms of, you know, how to collect data and how to analyze that. And we are very happy to collaborate with anyone with whom we can be of value, which I believe will, that comprises almost 100% of the of the set that we are talking. So not 100%, 99%, maybe 1% we are. So thank you so much. I think that's all is from my side. I would like to make it quick. And thank you so much, sir.
Thanks, Tarun. Thanks very much. Thanks for reinforcing the need for a data stack. We need more and more voices who can pitch for it so that we have a data stack going. So thanks very much for bringing that up. And yeah, what a nice way to... Go ahead, Tarun.
Yeah, I'm part of a committee where we are working to create data sets in the PMO, where we are working on horticulture, grains and oil seeds and spices and milk. So there's a full POC is going on. POC, not long. It's a defined POC. Not like the ones Mr. Guru mentioned, Dr. Guru mentioned. So we are working with to create that data stack and see how we can create one highway for data with every startup kind of, you know, being a part of it.
No, that's great. I think what we need is some pilots which can sort of go in the direction of building a pan-India multi-crop data stack that we all look forward to. I'm sure that in the next few years we should